Good evening. I'm Ron Burgundy, and this is Channel 4 News. Many composers have altered the sound of orchestral music dramatically over its evolution. And to celebrate the 147th anniversary of his birthday, tonight we have a special segment of the show devoted to one of them, Claude Debussy. A pioneer in the Romantic era of orchestral music, his composition altered the views on popular orchestral music in many ways. Debussy was born on the 22nd of August in the year 1862 in Saint-Germain-en-Laye in West Paris, France. His music career started at the age of four, when he had piano lessons from an elderly Italian woman, where from this very start he showed a large amount of musical talent. At 10, Debussy entered the Paris Conservatoire, where he studied music composition, music theory, piano and other attributes of music for the next 11 years. Between 1880 and 1882, Debussy was a music teacher to the children of Nadezhda von Meck, who happened to be the patroness of Peter Tchaikovsky, another great composer of the time. For composing L'Enfant, he won the Prix de Rome, which is a four-year scholarship to study at the Académie des Beaux-Arts. As a young composer, Debussy was very influenced by the works of the older Richard Wagner, but in due time he outgrew Wagner's style and wrote to his own accord. The term Impressionist has been used to describe Debussy, although he did not feel himself that this was a correct statement to make towards his music. Impressionist music is music that is suggestive but does not paint vivid concrete pictures. It lets the listener's imagination take over and make of the piece what they feel. Debussy's most recognisable piece would have to be Clair de Lune, the third movement from his piano suite, Suite Bergamasque. But the instruments that he writes for vary greatly throughout his full list of works. From operas and great orchestral compositions to simple piano sonatas and quartets for instruments of a single type. Debussy's personal life was very up and down throughout his whole life, with many unsuccessful relationships, affairs, and suicide attempts. After the attempted suicide of an ex-lover aroused scandal, he fled to England with his pregnant partner, Emma Barak. Debussy's life had come to a closing on the 25th of March, 1918, due to colonic cancer, but his legacy had just begun, leading composers such as Ralph Vaughan Williams to write impressionist music for many years to come. Debussy had a large influence on the orchestral music of his era, but he also affected other areas such as jazz and minimalism. 147 years ago, an extraordinary man was born, and to this day, his influence is still affecting the music we listen to. 147 years ago, a man was born called Claude Debussy. I am Ron Burgundy, and from the team here at Channel 4 News, you stay classy, San Diego.